Hey, I know that you know exactly what this video is about because, well, it's in the title, right? There must clearly be a part where I talk about how to procrastinate as a pro. And then there's clearly a part where I tell you how to get things done. But I've been told I have to find the hook, something that captures your interest, something that excites you, that makes you want to watch the next 5 or 10 minutes. Let me think about this. Step one, overthink everything. Make it as complicated as you can. If there is a simple solution, ignore it and find a more complicated one. Step two, do not draw any conclusions. If you catch your mind coming close to a solution, maybe you are coming that close to drawing a conclusion about the problem that you are thinking about, stop thinking. Just forget about it. Step three, make sure that you do not write anything down. You want to commit the most amount of information to your subconscious mind. You want to make sure that your subconscious mind is constantly occupied by all the small things in your life. You don't want to have any capacity for the big things. Step four, when you have a great idea, stop first and ask yourself whether there's something else that you could do instead, something that is fun, something that you enjoy, and then forget about that idea. Step five, make sure that you focus on two things at the same time, because you don't want your life to be boring. Step six, create an environment that stimulates you 24/7. Keep your phone at your bed. Watch YouTube when you get up. Set your alarm once an hour to check Instagram. Read every Medium article that you can find because you want to have an extraordinary amount of knowledge. If you face a quiet moment, call someone or text them. Make sure you fall asleep on the couch while the TV is still running, which leads me to step seven. Under no circumstances, plan for tomorrow. You want tomorrow to be as inefficient as today.
Gosh, that was depressing, wasn't it? And yet all of those things I've at some stage or the other observed in my own life. And we are prone to it. We sometimes are masters in procrastination, doing all the things that we know don't get us the result. And at the end of the day, we are none the wiser. But there are ways how we can use procrastination to our benefit. So let me share four of those things with you. And the first one is to use procrastination as a guide. See, there must be a reason why you procrastinate. And it usually falls into one of two areas. Number one is that you find the task so daunting and so hard that you just can't get yourself to do it. The second reason is interesting though. The second reason is that you find something so boring, so meaningless that you just put it back into the future. And if you observe yourself while you procrastinate, you are also able to filter out all the things that maybe keep you away from your true purpose in life. And the reality is that for most of us, that accounts for more than 50% of the things that we procrastinate on. Now imagine how much more energy that will give you for all the other tasks, the hard tasks, the meaningful ones that you procrastinate on because you don't feel ready for it, but now you do have the energy. The second way to make procrastination work for you is to embrace it. Let's be real, we are not productive all of the time. We have off days. We have times when we are not that creative, when we just can't think of solutions to a problem. In those cases, procrastination can actually help us. So maybe you change environment, go outside for a walk. You take a break and listen to your favorite podcast. Or you listen to a few things that help you get into the mind of the problem that you are trying to solve. Rather than beating yourself up about the time that you waste and procrastinate, plan a break around it. Plan how you can set alternatives that may not give you the immediate solution to your problem, but that will also make you feel good about the time spent there. And once you take your mind off a problem, that's usually when the solution comes to you. The third way to make procrastination work for you is that you park an idea. But you have to park it in the right way. Sometimes we think about a solution, we park it in our brain and we say, I don't know about it yet, let me do something else first. Don't do that, but rather take a pen and write down a few things. What is the problem? What are the alternatives? And why did I stop thinking about it? And now that you've written it down, go about your day and do the things that you need to do. Because you've given your brain an incentive to solve the problem. And once you come back to it, you don't lose any momentum because you already know what the problem is and what the alternatives are, why you stopped, and where to take it from here. The fourth way to take something positive out of procrastination is the opposite of what I talked about earlier. See, we talked about something being boring and meaningless. But equally, you can look at the task and make it more interesting and meaningful to your life. Maybe your goal became misaligned with the action that you're taking. It reminds me of something that my dad said quite a few times. He said, I love paying taxes. The more taxes, the better. Which is quite funny, but if you think about it, the more taxes you pay, the more you earn, so it becomes something positive. And suddenly, that tax return isn't something boring and meaningless, but it shows what you have achieved over the past year. But it also has a second element, which is that we don't have to sweat the small stuff. Some things in life are just not as interesting. Some things we just have to get over with. We don't have to beat ourselves up that sometimes we procrastinate on them. We embrace it, but we can put meaning back into those tasks by asking ourselves what the reason is for the task that we are about to do. And if that connects back to our purpose, we are far more motivated. Right, no more procrastination. In very quick succession, before you lose any time, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and watch me next time because I look forward to seeing you there.